Guys, a very very warm welcome to Arihant Online Academy. In this session, we are going to discuss very very important MCQs for the UGC NET and JRF Computer Science. It is a mini mock test 5, and first 4 mini mock tests we have already discussed, whose link is given into the description section. So go through them. The question number 1 here is, which of the following is a sequential circuit? The option A is multiplexer, decoder, counter or full adder. So multiplexer, decoder and full adder, they are sequential circuit, they are combinational circuit, they are combinational circuits, guys, combinational circuits. And only counter is the option which you can say that it is a sequential circuit. Okay, so option C is the right answer. The next question is, 8085 microprocessor has how many hardware interrupts? So 8085 microprocessor have 5 hardware interrupts. If I name it, it can be like TRAP, T-R-A-P. The next one is RST 7.5. Another one is RST 6.5. The another one is RST 5.5. And one more is INTR. Okay, so these are the 5 interrupts, hardware interrupts, which existed in 8085 microprocessor. And if we talk about 8086 microprocessor, then in 8086 microprocessor basically we have 2 hardware interrupts. Basically we can name it like NMI and INTR. Okay, but here in this question 8085 is asked, so 5 hardware interrupts is there, but you can keep note of 8086 as well because they may ask, so at that time you need to answer too if they ask in the scenario of 8086. Okay, so option D is the correct answer for question number 2. The next question is, which one of the following array represents a binary max heap? So I hope you all know the concepts of max heap. So if I go through the option A, 26, then 13, then 17, then 14. Here itself my binary max heap property fails, because in binary max heap say that the root element should be maximum at every stage, but here 14 is in the 14 is the child of 13, which is not possible in the definition of max heap. So option A is the wrong. Option B, 26, 15, 14, then 17. Again 17, which is more weight, and it is a child of lesser weight, that is 15. So again max heap property is failed. So option B is also not the answer. Option C, 26, 15 and 17, both are less than 26, no problem. Then 14 and 11, 14 and 11, both are less than 15, no problem. Then 9 and 13, both are less than 17. So at each level, at each node, we are following the property of binary max heap. So option C is the correct answer. The next question is, if link transmits 4000 frames per second, 4000 frames per second, and each slot has 8 bits, and each slot have 8 bits, then the transmission rate of the circuit of the TDM is, so basically transmission rate is frames per second multiply with the available bits. It is nothing but 32,000. You can say that 32 kbps. So option C is the correct answer, guys. The next question is, the register that stores all interrupt requests is, so it is a theoretical question. Basically interrupt request register is the name which stores all interrupt requests. So option C is the correct answer. Next question is, which of the following is false regarding the evaluation of computer programming languages? Application oriented feature, it is considered when we talk about computer programming language. Efficiency and readability, software development, basically A, B and C, they are a part of software evaluation, they are part of computer programming language. But hardware maintenance cost, it is out of the box. So option D is the answer, it is not evaluated when we talk about computer programming languages. So option D is the correct answer for question number 6. The question number 7 is, which of the following statements is not correct? HTML is not a screen precise formatting language. So it is true, it is correct. HTML does not specify a logic. It is also correct. DHTML is used for developing highly interactive web pages, dynamic HTML. It is also correct. HTML is a programming language. This is not true. This is not correct, because HTML is a hypertext markup language. It is not a programming language. Option D is the correct answer. The next question is software safety is quality assurance activity that focuses on hazards that basically software safety is a quality assurance activity that focuses on may cause an entire system to fail. Option B is the correct answer. Theoretical question, directly note the answer and go through that because it is previous year UGC NET question. Next question is which of the following sets represents five stages defined by CMM, that is capability maturity model. Very very important. You can watch CMM lecture in our software engineering playlist. You are where you can get complete lecture, complete concept of that. And we need to answer the increasing order of maturity model. So first initial, then repeatable, then defined, then managed, and then optimized. Option B is the correct answer. The next one is in Unix, processes that have finished execution but have not yet had their status collected are known as zombie processes. Zombie processes are the processes which have finished the execution but didn't collect the status. It's called a zombie process. Sleeping processes are the processes which are in the processor but not executing. Or you can say that in the resting condition, stopped processor which have completely stopped, and off-home processes basically its parent processes have finished and executed successfully, but child processes are still executing. That are called as off-home processes. But in the question, in Unix processes that have finished the execution but not yet had their status collected yet is are called as zombie processes. Option C is the correct answer. So guys, do solve first four mini mock tests as well. And if any kind of doubts or queries, do comment us. I will try to solve them as early as possible. Have a very, very nice day, guys. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.